Amen. I'm looking forward to the day that it's all over. You know, my day may be over for some of y'all's. And if really time takes its course, it will be. Probably before most of you, except Brother Doyle back there. And we may go about the same time. Hallelujah. But I'm looking forward to the day whenever the resurrection takes place. I said when the resurrection takes place. And if I'm walking around here on the earth. Hallelujah. Said if I'm walking around here on the earth and I hear that trumpet sound, this old body's going to be changed in a moment and a twinkling of an eye. And we're going to go to beat him in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. But the dead in Christ are coming out first.
Right, right.
Y'all don't feel what I feel. I said, y'all don't feel what I feel. I feel the Holy Ghost here today. Hallelujah. Amen. I was thinking about some of the things Brother Harrington was saying a while ago about people being feeling like they just can't be saved. My brother, we were raised in the right church. The way I had the Holy Ghost. My wife had the Holy Ghost. My sisters had the Holy Ghost. My mother and daddy had the Holy Ghost. And my brother said, I can't be saved. Because there's got to be one out of the family to be lost. That was his words. You know what? He came to church one Sunday morning, thinking he was just going to come in and sit down, sit through a service, and leave. And the Holy Ghost got to moving. And we had a woman that didn't even live right. Didn't know it at the time. But she gave out a message in tongues and interpreted those tongues. And brother, he jumped up from that pew is where he was at. Run to the altar, repented of his sins.
Praise the Lord.
Didn't get the Holy Ghost right then.
Praise the Lord.
But I was gonna baptize him that afternoon. In the Arlington Lake. We didn't have a baptistry back then. But you know what? While we was getting ready to go, the evangelist that was with me was going to ride over there with my brother to the lake. And my sister got a hold of him, my older sister. She walked up to him and started put her arms around his neck, started dancing and speaking in tongues. And the Holy Ghost got to moving. And the first thing you know, he was dancing and speaking in tongues. And he got the Holy Ghost. He died at 50 years old in a car wreck. He died. But he was ready to go to meet the Lord. I'm here to tell you right now, there ain't nobody that can't be saved. There's only one person, one kind of person that can't be saved. And that's people that blaspheme the Holy Ghost. And they have to have had the Holy Ghost before they can blaspheme the Holy Ghost. And if they do that, then they're doomed to be lost. But I'm here to tell you right now, there's nobody sitting here in this place right now or standing here in this place right now that can't be saved. We all can be saved. It's all if we make up our minds. I'm going to obey the gospel of Jesus Christ. And I'm going to live for God after I obey the gospel of Jesus Christ. Well, glory. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I thought about scripture. I'm probably not going to read nothing. I'm not going to preach what I had here because I don't feel like it. Amen. I just don't feel like starting in on that. But I'm here. You can be seated if you want to. And I'm here to tell you right now, my Bible tells me if the words spoken by angels were steadfast and ever disobedient and had their just recompense of reward, how shall we escape if we neglect so great salvation, which at the first began to be spoken by the Lord and was confirmed unto us by them that heard him? Ha ha. What was that gospel that they preached? What was the gospel that Jesus preached? Yeah. One of the first things he said, repent and be converted. Hallelujah. He talked about repentance. Hallelujah. I'm telling you right now, he began to teach his people. And they walked with him for 3.5 years. And they listened to what he had to say. Oh, Lord, I feel the Holy Ghost right about now. Hallelujah. They listened to what he had to say. And just before he ascended into heaven. Just before he ascended into heaven. Oh, God, help me. Brother James, I don't know. I don't know. I feel like God wants to do something around here this morning. But right before he ascended into heaven. Oh, hallelujah. He was standing up there with them just before he ascended. And he said, go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I've commanded you. And lo, I'm with you always, even to the end of the world. Yeah, he did. That was Matthew's interpretation of it. And then Luke said it a different way. And Mark said it a different way. John didn't say it at all. But he said, go ye and tarry in Jerusalem till you be endued with power from on high. They went back to Jerusalem. They got there in the upper room and they waited. There's about 500 brethren that heard him say that. What the Bible said. But whenever they just stayed there in the upper room and some left, had to have because there's 500 to start out with. Some of them left. Some of them stayed. And they left. Those that left just missed out. Hallelujah. But they stayed in that upper room. I don't know how many, probably about 10 days, something like that. They were up there. Can you imagine being in a prayer meeting for 10 days? I'm sure you had to sleep sometime. Hallelujah. But they were up there. And suddenly, there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as a fire. Didn't say tongues of fire. It said tongues like as a fire. There wasn't no tongues of fire on their heads like you see in the pictures. I'm going to tell you what it was. It set on Brother Peter. And he began to speak in tongues. Jumped over here to Brother John. He began to speak in tongues. Brother Andrew. Amen. And Brother James. That's me. Brother James. But anyway, hallelujah. It hit each one of them. Amen. They began to speak in tongues and magnify God. And it got noised abroad. It got noised abroad. They began to, people again, ooh, what's going on down there on Straight Street? Hallelujah. What's going on? Hey, them people was up there shouting. Now they're down the street and they're worshiping and having a time, speaking in languages they don't know. Oh, these preachers tell you don't need to speak in no tongues. They don't know what they're talking about. They ain't read the Bible real good yet, I don't guess. Right. And even if they read it, they're discounting part of it. They're saying, this ain't for us. This ain't for us. Well, if it was for them, why ain't it for us? Why ain't it for us? Oh, hallelujah.
Yeah.
Amen. Oh, yeah, they were all standing up there looking, watching, and Peter began to preach.
Praise the Lord.
I said, Peter began to preach. I just feel like preaching this. I'm telling you, I am telling you. I had something completely different. Amen. I'm not going to deal with nobody this morning except for somebody that needs what God's got for him. Brother Matthew. Peter got to preaching to him. And he come on down, preached a while, preached about David and all the others there. And then he come down and he said, and ye, you Jews that are standing out there, you crucified the Lord of glory. And they were pricked in their hearts.
Yes.
Something happened to them.
Uh-huh.
And something happened to somebody around here today. I said, there's something happening to people around here today. I'm going to tell you, they were pricked in their hearts.
Uh-huh.
And they said, men and brethren, what shall we do?
Uh-huh.
What are we going to do? Men and brethren, we're guilty.
Right.
So what are we going to do?
Right.
Peter said, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of the Father, Son, Holy Ghost. Yeah. In the name of. In the name of. In the name of. Can I say it again? In the name of. He didn't say, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. But he told them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, which is the name of the Father, which is the name of the Son, which is the name of the Holy Ghost. Ha, ha, ha. Oh, yes. And brother, they all, there's a bunch of them got the Holy Ghost in that street out there and was baptized, about 5,000 of them. Now, I don't know how in the world the apostles baptized that many people, but they did.
Right. Amen.
Uh-huh. Oh, yes. I think about it. Matthew was standing there. He wrote that other.
He did.
He wrote it.
Yeah.
And he was standing there.
Right.
He heard him say that. Why didn't he say, whoa, wait a minute. You're telling them wrong.
Right.
You're telling these people wrong. I said to be baptized, every one of you, in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost.
Right.
He didn't do that. He didn't correct him. And I'm glad he didn't. Because I know, amen, my sins are forgiven.
Yes. Yes.
I know my sins are forgiven. I know they've been remitted. I know that ain't a song, but I'm singing it anyway. Hallelujah. I know my sins have been remitted. You know why? Thank God. For the blood. Thank God for the blood. Thank God for the blood that washes white as snow. I'm telling you, I got my sins remitted.
Yes.
He forgave them. He already forgave them. But then I got them remitted.
Yes. Yes.
Some men's sins go on to judgment.
Right.
Some men's sins follow after. Wonder who that's talking about. He's talking about ones that go on to judgment are the ones that get baptized in Jesus' name.
Yes, right.
They're judged and over with.
Right. Right.
Y'all ain't seen an old man dancing a long time, have you? I feel like dancing. Oh, I'm telling you. I am telling you. I feel about like dancing right now, and I wish I could. Ow! Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
There ain't nothing better.
Come on.
I said there ain't nothing better than to preach this word that I'm preaching right now. Nothing better. Woo! Hallelujah. 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 Oh, yeah. Got my sins remitted. They're gone. Now, I got to live right.
Right.
I got to walk right.
Right.
I got to talk right.
Uh-huh.
Yes, sir.
And I'm going to tell you something. You get your sins remitted. Praise the Lord, sister. You get your sins remitted. And when you get your sins remitted, they're gone.
Right.
But you ain't got the Holy Ghost yet. Not unless you got it before. Like I did. I got the Holy Ghost before I was baptized. I did. I spoke in tongues for several hours, not knowing for sure whether I was capable of living for God or not, because I tried it several times, and it just didn't work for me. For some reason, I'd end up going right back to the way I was. I'm going to tell you the reason why, though. I didn't have my mind made up. See, when I went that night, because standing in front of the church, God told me, he said, this is your last opportunity. He spoke that to me in my heart, and I knew it as well as I knew anything. And whenever he said that to me, I got myself inside that church, waited for that preacher to get through preaching, and I went to the altar, and I prayed, 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 and I prayed. Speaking in tongues. I had to have it. It had to happen for me like that. A lot of people, all they got to do is just speak in tongues a few words, and they got it. They got it from now on. Live for a God the rest of their life. But it took me that time to be sure that everything was going to be all right. And whenever I got up in that altar, I knew beyond a shadow of a doubt that I was going to live for God the rest of the days of my life. Old devil's been after me a lot of times, saying, you ain't right. You ain't doing right. You ain't living right. And sometimes he was right. Now, I know most of y'all probably never do anything wrong. You know, after you get the Holy Ghost baptized in Jesus' name, you never sin again. No, I don't know that either. But I'm here to tell you right now. John had provision for that. First John, he said, my little children, I write unto you that you sin not. But if you sin, you have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous. I don't have to stop. I don't have to quit. I didn't have to quit when I done wrong. I just had to keep on going. I just had to repent and ask him to forgive me, just like I did at the altar to begin with. Repentance is never quit. You never quit repenting. You'll repent the rest of your life probably because you're going to do something sometime in your life that you're going to have to repent for. Yeah,
yeah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Good.
But I'm going to tell you, the Holy Ghost is so real.
Yes.
I said it's so real.
Yes.
These people out yonder in the world think they've got it. They really don't even know what it's all about. There's something inside of you. And when you get told to go, ain't this right? You got something inside of you. You just got it not long ago. Hallelujah. And it's something inside of you that's different than it was before. Hallelujah. Y'all know how many years I've been living for God? Almost 50. Almost 50 years. Well, next year it'll be 50. I've been living for 49 years now. And somebody said, after I got through, he won't make it. He won't make it. Somebody said, he's just too rotten before he got in church.
Mm-hmm.
Said, he just won't make it. But I'm here to tell you, I don't care how rotten you are.
Right.
I don't care how eat up with pornography.
Mm-hmm.
I don't care how eat up you are with anything.
Right.
If you really want to serve the Lord, God will deliver you and set you free. I said, God will deliver you and set you free. Hallelujah. I'm going to tell you right now, I made up my mind that whenever I got right with God and got the Holy Ghost, I was going to live for him all of my life. I've even had some come and say, you don't need to do all you're doing. You know, you don't have to do all that. If I don't have to, why did God tell me to? That's what I'd like to know.
Right.
Why did God tell me I ought to live this way?
Right.
And I mean, he spoke to me personally and told me the way I ought to live. And then they come along and try to tell me that I ain't supposed to live this way. They done come barking up the wrong tree. I'm telling you right now, I know beyond a shadow of a doubt how I'm supposed to live, and I'm going to live it the rest of the days of my life. Amen. If it hair lifts, all the devils in hell and everything around, every person around. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. God can do the same for every one of you here today. If you're struggling with your salvation,
I'm telling
you right now,
come on,
God knows how.
Yeah.
There's some of you here struggling right now, I feel.
Come on. Yes, sir.
I feel like I said that because God wanted me to say it. There's some of you here struggling right now. You have a problem getting ready to come to church. You have a problem, amen, trying to make do everything you're supposed to do. Well, I'm here to tell you right now, you better make up your mind. It's just about over. I said, it's just about over. Yes. Jesus Christ is coming after his church.
Yes, he is.
Come on, yes.
Mighty God.
Yes.
And he hadn't been washed in the blood of Jesus Christ and your name written in the Lamb's Book of Life.
Right.
I'm glad my name is there.
Yes. Praise the Lord.
I'm so glad my name is there.
Praise the Lord.
He wrote it down
mm-hmm.
a long time ago. And I'm glad my name is there.
Praise the Lord.
In the Lamb's Book of Life.
Yes.
You know, Revelation says the people are going to stand before God.
Right.
And the books are going to be opened. That's talking about 66 books of the Bible.
Mm-hmm.
And another book was opened, which was the Book of Life. And he began to look through it. As people come up, he looked through this Book of Life. Lamb Book of Life. Looking at the names. Looking at the names. Have you got your name written in the Lamb's Book of Life?
Mighty God.
Have you got your name written in the Lamb's Book of Life? If you haven't, you better get it there.
Yes.
Because it ain't going to be long. The way this world is going right now, I can tell you right now, the way the world is going, we may be under a dictatorship before this year is out.
Right.
It wouldn't surprise me not one bit that he declares martial law and end up a dictator in this United States of America.
Right, right.
One of these days you're going to stand before God. All both small and great, rich or poor, bond or free, are going to stand before God. And that's when you're going to be judged for the deeds that you've done in your body. I'm here, I'm telling you right now, you better get yourself mind made up. If you're in this church and you're not happy with what you're doing, you better get yourself in an altar somewhere. You don't have to be here. But you better get yourself in an altar somewhere and cry out to God until you get satisfied in your soul. You get to the point to where you know beyond a shadow of a doubt, if you were to die, if I was to die this minute right now, sister, I'll go to heaven.
Come on, come on.
I ain't worried one iota about it. Even though I know I've done wrong, I've always repented. And I know beyond a shadow of a doubt, if God stopped this ticker of mine right now, I would die and I'd go to the grave. And at the end of this all, when this is all over with, he's going to raise me up and I'll go to be with him. I know. I said, I know. I know my sins are forgiven. I know. No doubt in my mind.
Right.
You can try it any other way. You can try to go another way. But my Bible tells me that he's the door of the sheepfold. No man climbeth up any other way.
Mm-hmm.
The same as a thief and a robber if they try to climb up a different way.
Right. The word.
Ha!
Yes,
I feel the Holy Ghost so strong right now. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Don't try to make it a different way. Don't believe. Easy believism is going to get you in. You've got to do more than believe.
Right.
You've got to obey
right.
after you believe.
Right.
Believe is the first step.
Uh-huh.
I said belief is the first step. You go the first step when
That's
you believe.
It. That's it.
And the second step
uh-huh.
is whenever God convicts your heart of your sins and you ask him to forgive you of those sins. The next step is water baptism in the name of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
And the final step is getting filled up with the Holy Ghost.
Right. Yes.
And then living for God the rest of the days of your life. Haboshakanabotaya. Ila Mahosha. One of these days you're going to preach this way. One of these days you're going to preach like this. You're going to be able to just let the anointing of the Holy Ghost get a hold of you. And I know you do now. But you don't know how it's going to be one of these days. You too. Hallelujah. One of these days, I'm telling you, when the anointing of the Holy Ghost gets on you, amen, everything else is it's just blank. I don't have no friends. I don't have no family. I don't have nobody except just God right now. Amen, because the anointing of the Holy Ghost is upon me to preach His word. Hallelujah. And I'm here to tell you right now, you better get right. I said, you better get right. You better get right. You better get right. You better get right. You better stay right. This up and down, back and forth, has got to stop. Ow! Ow!
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Have your way, Jesus. Have your way, Lord. Praise you, God. Hallelujah. Praise God.
Hey, Father. Hey, Messiah, Ilobo Kuyate, Inana the Messiah, Hallelujah to Messiah. These altars are open right now. If there's anybody that wants to pray, Halabo Shakana Mahai. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Others coming. Is there others coming? Hallelujah. If you need to pray yourself through to the Holy Ghost, amen. And you've been hadn't been living right, and you have been dissatisfied with your salvation, come on to this altar right now. Hallelujah. Do your best to get right with God. Hallelujah. Shadamokilia to Mosiah. Hallelujah, Mosiah. Ayah, Motiah. There's no better time than right now. Today is the day of salvation. Now is the accepted time. Today.